really played, and they recorded it. So yeah. We played the song a bunch of times.
I think there was some discussion of us lip-syncing to the track, and we're like, no, we're not going to do that, man. So yeah. For the people to talk, it's got to be on tape, and we're like, okay, well, we'll play the songs, and you can record us. We did until we thought they were good enough. And then kind of lip-sync back to your live performance, you know, while they're dancing yeah. around in the audience while we're playing in the background or whatever. So that was kind of odd, just, yeah. you know, first kind of experience around filmmaking.
Yeah, we weren't in a real club. They made a fake yeah. club, a movie type one, in a
empty pier downtown.
Yeah, in a pier down on the waterfront.
I was there when they filmed that scene. It was some of the most impressive hair flipping I've ever seen in my life. I mean, Seattle bands are really good hair flippers, but this was kind of the most hair flipping. They took the total prize for hair flipping with that one.
Long-running argument, and here it is. It says that when you come to a place like this, you can't just be yourself, you have to have an act. So anyway, I saw you standing there, so I thought, A, I could just leave you alone, B, I could come up with an act, or C, I could just be myself. I chose C. What do you think?
I think that A, you have an act, uh-huh. and that B, not having an act is your act.
Thank you.
Come here, I got a present for you. Give me another chance. 2 minutes. Come on. Hey. This would be great.
Oh.
You're gonna love me for this.
Hmm.
I installed your new stereo.
Oh. Great.
Want to see how I look? Rewind and freeze frame. But I am not about looks.
Hi. I crave responsibility, respectability, and love. My goals are serenity and knowledge and men who can understand me. Oh, no druggies, please. I'm fairly intense. And I'm an advertising exec at KRWE-TV. That's me.
Come to where the flavor is. Come to Debbie Country.
Just a little longer. Okay.
Whatever. I feel like I'm being pulled inside here.
You're being too loud. What are you thinking right now?
Yeah, I just go out and just play basketball, good hard-nosed basketball. Things happen throughout the course of the game. It's nothing you can do. I don't go out to look to say I'm going to beat this guy up or beat that guy up.
Anything else, X?
Yes, Steve, don't come yet.
I used to live out by the airport underneath the flight patterns. It was really noisy with the planes going by all day. And I used to have cookouts and no one would come because of the noise. I got used to it. And then when I moved, I missed the noise. I missed those planes.
Cliff, what are you talking about?
Lovemongers were our escape hatch from the 1980s. By the end of the 80s, everybody in music was kind of sick of the 80s. We were on MTV and we were wearing the clothes and all that, but we didn't want to do Heart. We just wanted to put it on hiatus and make something else.
We kind of decided to hang up our hats and go home to Seattle and start a band that was just for fun, just out of pocket, no record company, no management company, no label, you know, just on our own.
The rock music scene was really in a state of revolution, and we became friends with all the guys from around here who were making great music and starting to have success themselves.
We went back to clubs, and we took a couple of our great friends.
Our own version of kind of like the Traveling Wilburys, I think.
And we put them in our band, and we went out with a keyboard that also had drum programs. So we didn't have a drummer for a while. We were just playing to drum tracks.
No expectations on the Lovemongers that were on Heart. We didn't do Magic Man or Barracuda or anything like that.
And it was really fun. It was expensive, but it was really fun.
The debut of the Lovemongers on record would have been The Battle of Evermore on the single soundtrack.
We were like so thrilled, you know, because it wasn't even Heart. It was our little fledgling friend band getting into a movie soundtrack.
I've seen Lovemongers play The Battle of Evermore a few times live, and it's incredible.
We felt that it really showed off the Lovemongers, the power, the acoustic power, you know.
Well, it was something we were already doing in clubs because we knew the song and we're just doing songs we love to do.
We notoriously like Led Zeppelin, but we like a different side of Led Zeppelin, you know. The heart of that band was always acoustic, and that's why we were drawn to it.
Ann and Nancy could get up there and be Robert Plant, Jimmy Page, and John Paul Jones, just the two of them all at once in a way that kind of blows me away.
I think Cameron decided to put it in the soundtrack album because it was a cool vibe that needed to be there.
It was a real honor to get to be on that record. So many other amazing bands on that record. It sort of was a glorification of what was going on in Seattle to bring them all together.
Talking here with Cliff Pontier. Cliff, any comments on the Seattle sound and Citizen Dick's place in it?
Well, I don't like to reduce us just as being part of the Seattle sound. I like to think of us expanding more. Like, we're huge in Europe right now. I mean, we've got records, a big record just broke in Belgium. Into the blood again.
Same old trip it was bad. Now, a song like Touch Me, I'm Dick is about what?
Well, I think Touch Me, I'm Dick, in essence, speaks for itself, you know. I think that's basically what the song is about. It's about, you know, I think a lot of people might think it's actually about, you know, my name is Dick, and, you know, you can touch me, but I think, you know, it can be seen.
Look at some of the great music that's featured in the movie singles. Oh, Singles, the movie?
Music plays an important role in Singles. The movie soundtrack is studded with alternative favorites and Seattle heavyweights, but the bands aren't just heard in the background, they're in the movie.
For once you have musicians in a movie and it's not a caricature or a stereotype. They're just real guys reading their first bad review and checking the lead singer's face to see how they're doing.
I don't want to hear anything negative. Go on.
There's a band in there called Citizen Dick. Amazing band. Amazing drummer.
Drummer's a hack.
Well, anyway. Yeah, he is, but he's an amazing hack.
You guessed it, Pearl Jam's Eddie Vedder, Jeff Ament, and Stone Gossard make their big screen debuts by playing the backup band to the not-so-talented lead singer Cliff Consier, played by Matt Dillon.
Cliff, any comments on the Seattle sound and Citizen Dick's place in it?
Well, I don't like to reduce us just as being part of the Seattle sound. I like to think of us expanding more. Like, we're huge in Europe right now. I mean, we've got records... A big record just broke in Belgium.
He looks good in the wig, too. He actually used Eddie's hair as a replica to make this wig. So
just gross. Just
matted.
Not a...
He actually
looks... Well, let's make a wig of that.
He looks pretty street. He kind of looks like a combination of Eddie and Chris Cornell.
Chris Cornell also does a cameo in the film, and Seattle club scenes in the movie feature real-life Seattle bands, Soundgarden and Alice in Chains.
We did one song for the soundtrack, but we also did another song off the old album. So we were playing for like two consecutive tunes through this whole section. So it's going to be kind of interesting to see, you know, especially being in the movie that long, be totally red-faced by about the first second and probably walk out after that.
Those are the kind of bands that you would see in a small club in Seattle where you'd go just to get out of your house for the night. You would see Soundgarden playing in that club. You would see Alice in Chains playing someplace. And even now, after they've been visited by great success, I think they still would, and they still do stuff like that.
The rest of the guys took jobs at Boeing. They didn't get it. They weren't with the program. But I'm solo now. I'm doing some really, really interesting things. That's my latest. Playing that record in France.
Good luck.